Hi guys. It started off as a nice sunny bright day and then it clouded over and eventually it decided to rain. Well, we only had a bit of a shower, but it's supposed to get worse than that during the week. Anyway, you will notice the old blue, as I call it, has gone from the lounge. It's downstairs. I did a few touches downstairs. I had to sort the mudguard out because the bolts weren't holding it on securely. Someone had just whacked a couple of screws in there that weren't actually screwed in or anything. They were just sitting in the hole, so I don't see the point in those. But I've put a couple of proper bolts. So that's preventing the mudguard from scraping on the wheel. And then I forgot I had to tighten up the left hand cotter pin, so the crank on that side was wobbling all over the place. So did all that, that's done, that rides nicely. What else have I done? I need to have a bit of a tidy up in this lounge. The lights have gone, I have done that job. Couldn't put a shelf in there because I realised or remembered I used that one for a shelf down in the shed. Oops, my bad. Anyway, this is where they are now. All nicely. I managed to get all, I didn't think I would. I didn't think there was enough shelf space, but I managed to get them all. I've hung these two up. Because, that's better that way. And, yeah, I've got them all hung up. I will do a proper full update video on these and, just give a quick, well, a bit more info, as far as what I know about them anyway. I'm actually getting hungry. I'm going to turn the oven on. I've got a choice. I can put some chips in the oven and do some sausages on the Georgie, or I could get rid of that. Oh, keep in there. Let's put the temperature around to 200. Turn the oven on, there we go. Put in a pizza, because I've got a pizza in the freezer. I don't know, I'm not really feeling pizza at the minute. I've got all my 70s Lego over there. I do have a idea, because I was thinking of some display lights, perhaps. Fitted up there. I've got some suitable lights I can use. Bit of Ross is itching on my ankle. Yeah, I am gonna have a tidy up in here because I've got bits here, there, and everywhere, and I need to have a tidy up in the bedroom as well. Got some empty boxes. That box there can go out on the landing, on the shelving. A few bits to go out there. I've got those boxes to put back under there and drawers to put back, and yeah, I'll get there eventually. Got some Lego up here to sort still. It's been sitting there for, I don't know, 2 weeks now, I suppose. Nice close up view of me high vis coat there. Stand my zip ties in there. A couple of empty carrier bins. Find a place to stuff that. That mop head's broken. It's split so I can just pull a handle out like that. But the handle is still good, so. There's the split. I don't even know how it got split, to be honest. It must have fell over, I got stood on. That's alright, I can probably find a replacement mop head. I've got another mop there that I'm using at the moment. Ouch, just banged my elbow. Oh yeah. I was actually having a look on eBay, because I was watching, I've been watching quite a lot of videos from BigClive.com. I do like his videos, I do like his, humorous ones, and his joke ones, and his teardowns of random Poundland electric devices. I mean, well, really, you can't expect a lot for something from Poundland, can you? You know? They sell them cheap for a reason. But, I want to get into, well, hobby electronics, I'll say. I don't want to get heavily into it. But, I have been wanting to get some electronic bits, and I was actually, I just eBayed, did an eBay, fuck it. I did an eBay search for electronic kits and found some starter kits with all the breadboard, and you get a bunch of capacitors and all sorts of stuff with it. So I figured, yeah, I could get a couple of those, I suppose. It's a start, you know. What best place to start than with a starter kit? So, chuck and start clearing all this. Those videotapes, I'm going to stick back in that cupboard, I think. I'm going to sort this box of dynamo lights out, because I've got brackets and crap and all sorts in there that need to come out. I'm going to take the batteries out of this. My little dove is back up on the window. I don't know why she keeps sitting on that window. And I was actually resting my arms on the window ledge. That's how close she'll let me get. I was actually resting and leaning on the window ledge there, and she was still up there, though. She don't care. But I've done nothing to deliberately spook her or anything either. I've just respected her. You know, I've let her sit there. She's not bothering me. Apart from with her bloody cooing every now and again. I've got brackets and things I've got to chuck in there. I've got other random things I might chuck in there out of the way. Got a rechargeable battery, you know. No idea if it's going to take charge. Hello. That's its fault. I'll have to get the magnifying glass out and see if that's a 6-volt light bulb. So I know which compartment to put it in. It doesn't matter. Right. I want that cat eye light down there, don't I? I want to put it on one of the mountain bikes, but I haven't decided which yet. He's still up there. She's waiting for a boyfriend for me. So I know I've got a pair of doves that, they've hung around this area for a few years now. They've had one successful nest. They didn't nest last year. It was the year before that, the nest was attacked and I found the babies dead on the nest. Yep, the boyfriend's arrived. Ouch. Nope, he's up on the gutter now. I'm not sure what that noise was. I'm not sure if it's... Oh no, there's someone outside by the bins. That's alright. That's alright. I wasn't sure at first if that was the dove up on the guttering or... A bin that needs to be emptied. It's full of crap. I'm getting somewhere though. A bit of wire, that ain't no good. Instructions, they've got to go into. I need to, No, because if I put these in there, I'm going to forget. I've got some tools and things. All my solder and whatnot and soldering iron will all go on the desk when it's clear. The camera will probably stack down there when I've got the videos cleared. I ain't got a clue what I'm going to do with the motherboard yet. Or where I'm going to sit my fluff. Oh, I don't know where I'm going to sit the squirrels. I'm going to sit under here. And then one side I'll probably stack my little tool kits in like that. And running out of space. Keep moving things around. Right. What's this? Drill. Go in that tray. These bits of Lego can go in the other room. Oop. So I can pick it all up. Mouse mat. I may actually have to put the mouse mat back into action because I'm wearing the varnish off on the table already. So I'll give that a try. If not, I'll have to look into getting a new one. But I did put several electronic kits and starter sets and things in my watch list. Because they're not expensive. And at least some of them, because I want to practice soldering as well. And you can get some really cheap project kits on eBay. So I was going to get a few. Start cheap, because if any, as Big Clive, what video was that? That was the one where he was assembling that digital clock, which I think cost him £1 and some odd pence on eBay. I did find the clock. I'm not sure if it's the same seller, but I did find the clock on eBay, and I'll get that, because for that silly money it wouldn't matter if you cock it up, really, would it? Because yeah, practicing soldering at least. It'll be interesting if to find out if I can get it to work the first time, though. Considering I've got a cheap piece of crap soldering on. It does actually work, though. I prefer one with a pointed tip. But, never mind, I can always upgrade later. Drill down here. Shit on the bed to clear. I've got the fan in bits because all the cage is clogged with his hair. Especially the back cage, where the air is sucked into the fan. So, when I remember where I put my brush, I'll brush it out. Stupid thing is, it was on the floor down here the other day, and now it's disappeared. Could be anywhere. Damn it, I forgot to put the bloody bell on again. Some batteries in here, I'll stick the meter on and see how dead they actually are. Well, that is actually all I've got left of the Gary Fisher mountain bike that got stolen in February, because I had just changed the batteries and the headlamp. So, yeah. That's all that remains. And I've just changed the lighting layout on it as well. My fault, I suppose, because I should have locked the damn thing up. But can't change it now, can I? I've got me clawed, so I suppose it wasn't all bad. Get what I can done on this desk today. I was actually thinking of getting some of those drawers I've used for the Lego and stacking maybe in there. Just so I've got something to put all the little bits in when I get these electronic kits and whatnot, and fit the light to the desk maybe later. I've got the cordless in here, and it's just a matter of working out where I want the light and zipping a couple of screws in here to slide it onto. Actually, I know exactly where I can get a couple of screws from. I suppose I could keep my eyes open for disposed of electrical items to salvage bits out of for various projects. And I don't know, I just want to have a play and practice my soldering, that's all. Because I used to be able to do it pretty well. Many years ago, and I haven't done it for years, but repairing that bike light was successful, at least. Oh, I've got a couple of batteries in that one. Just to see, I've got this really awful habit that instead of clearing up as soon as I've done one job or one project, I let everything build up. Then I just end up with crap here, there and everywhere. I apologise for that noise. I'm just getting batteries out of the lights. I don't like leaving lights with batteries in. One, because I'll use them elsewhere. Two, because I use cheap ones like this, they're more prone to going bad quickly and leaking. Trust me, been there, done that. There's batteries in there. Night Rider. Don't think I've got a bracket for that one. Another one Biggles gave me. When he sorted out his workshop tour last year, I believe now. There's loads of old lights like that he gave me that he'd collected up. Fuck it, that one. Fuck it, I can go in there as well. I know where it is, that's the main thing. Just wondering why I've got this here. These are actually the battery lamps I want to fit to old blue. Where did I put the other pair? In the bed. I've got another, another front one in there somewhere. Right. It smells like the oven is getting nice and hot. I haven't really got much else planned for the day, other than finishing the, or, well, not finishing it, but doing some more to the electronics desk. It's where I could store my light bulbs, actually, because I'll be more likely to use them up there. Oh, a couple of bulbs here. Put those back in here. Put those in there as well, because I believe there's 6 voltages in them. Bung them in there. Got a bit of a sort out in my desk tidy here as well. I'm looking for a couple of these bulbs, because they're 6 voltages. If I remember correctly. that and just go in there. There we go. Well, wouldn't mind finding somewhere that does a load of these, because they're quite handy and I am starting to run low. Right, yeah, so we're going to put the chips in the oven and turn Mr. George on. Actually, I might give it 5 or 10 minutes before I turn the grill on. So, so much bloody crap. I've got carrier bags coming at me backside, but I don't want to throw them away. Because if I do start selling items on eBay again... Oh, that reminds me. Someone did reply to my ad with the Optima. Found the message this morning. They want to come and get it, which will hopefully be tomorrow lunchtime. I'm just going to see if they have actually replied any more. Yep. Yep. You said it might be a bit later than 12, because that was my first time I gave, because I'm pretty flexible anyway. But you said it might be later than that because he's got a work meeting or something. I can't remember what he said now. So I said, well, you know, 12:30 would be okay with me if that's any help. You know, I'm flexible, so I'm not going anywhere tomorrow. So he can pretty much just turn up whenever he's ready. So hopefully that'll be 20 squids in my pocket. Just made me even more tempted to go and get that muddy fox out of the trailer and do that one. Because, that would be another score in my pocket. And I'd have probably done the orange Apollo out there if I could have got that seat post to move, but it doesn't want to move. I might have a go. Because, I've got a nice shiny crank I can stick on it. Didn't cost me anything, so... I can throw a nice crank on it, because the one on it is rusty, and apart from the paintwork, you know. Or I could even keep that one for myself if I can bash the seat post down a bit. It's a bit too tall. But it's the wrong colour for the project I want to do. And I don't... If I can avoid painting, I will. Yeah. So, there'll probably be another late night vlog done as well, so I'm going to say goodbye, and thanks for watching, as always. If you liked the video, hit the like button. If you didn't, hit the dislike button. If you don't feel like hitting either buttons, then don't hit either button. It's up to you. Do what you like. And subscribe if you haven't, and I'll talk to you again soon. Bye.